Welcome back to the ever-enthralling CosmoNexus, your trusted gateway to the cosmic realm. I'm Adam Collins, your guide on this celestial journey. Today's agenda. A captivating query: what is the reach of sunlight in the infinite expanse of space? Buckle up and prepare to embark on another exciting cosmic voyage. Let's delve into the unique dialect of starlight, a language that astronomers have been studying, decoding, and interpreting for centuries. The conversation begins with the concept of magnitude, our metric for quantifying the luminosity of stars and other celestial bodies. Picture the night sky as a cosmic theater, where some actors, the stars, outshine the rest. The magnitude is categorized into two types: apparent and absolute. The apparent magnitude measures the brightness of a star as perceived by an observer on Earth, analogous to the volume level of a track on your music system. A star that seems luminous from our planet has a low apparent magnitude number. Sirius, the most radiant star in our night sky, boasts an apparent magnitude of -1.46. Conversely, a dimmer star will register a higher apparent magnitude number. Interestingly, the concept of apparent magnitude hails from the era of ancient Greece. Back then, the Greeks sorted stars into six magnitudes. First magnitude signified the most brilliant, and sixth magnitude denoted the dimmest, detectable to the naked eye. In present times, we've fine-tuned this system, accommodating even those stars and entities that outshine to the extent of having negative magnitudes. But remember, the universe is grandiose, and distances can be deceiving. Here, absolute magnitude comes to our aid. It adjusts for these spatial illusions by determining a star's brightness from a standard distance of 10 parsecs, equivalent to approximately 32.6 light years. It essentially tells us, if we line up all these celestial bodies, 32.6 light years away, which one would outshine the rest. So, where does our Sun, the star we hold dear, stand in this cosmic ranking? Interestingly, our Sun holds an absolute magnitude of around 4.8. If you found yourself 10 parsecs or 32.6 light years away, our Sun would resemble a dim star in the Little Dipper constellation. It's somewhat startling, isn't it? Our Sun, whose brilliant glare is blinding from our planet, would merely twinkle from such a distance. But the intriguing part doesn't end there. Imagine this: even from such a formidable distance, our Sun could still be perceived with the naked eye, potentially up to a whopping 70 light years away. This realization serves as a profound reminder of both the Sun's formidable power and the astounding vastness of the cosmos. It conjures an image of our Sun's radiance traversing the quiet depths of space, generously sharing its light with the boundless universe. Now, let's envision that we're positioned on Earth, eyes fixed on two luminous bodies, our Sun and Sirius, the most brilliant star visible from our planet. Yes, from our vantage point, the Sun outshines Sirius, but what happens when we commence a journey away from the Sun and towards Sirius? At which point does Sirius overtake the Sun in this cosmic competition? Imagine we board a spacecraft and set our course towards Sirius. As we venture forth, there will come a point when our Sun ceases to be the brightest star in our visual field. Unbelievably, that turning point lies approximately 1.5 light years from Earth, somewhere between us and Sirius. This distance might seem vast, but in the grand scheme of the cosmos, it equates to merely stepping out of our stellar backyard. It's crucial to remember that a voyage through space is simultaneously a voyage back in time. Each photon of light from Sirius reaching our eyes embarked on its journey 8.6 years prior. If your eyes are fully adjusted to darkness, they would be catching roughly 8 million photons per second originating from Sirius. Each of these photons, these minute parcels of light, serve as emissaries from the past, narrating the tale of Sirius. Let's refocus on our expedition. As we drift further from the Sun and closer to Sirius, the Sun's brilliance diminishes, and Sirius begins to shine brighter. The specific point at which Sirius outshines the Sun is around 17% of the journey towards Sirius, approximately 1.43 light-years from Earth. The experience is somewhat surreal, isn't it? Witnessing another star outclass our Sun, the celestial body we've always seen as the most radiant and dominant in our sky, is quite astonishing. Yet, the universe is boundless, housing countless stars, each with their unique narratives of light and darkness. As we traverse the cosmos, our viewpoint is constantly shifting, continually challenging our understanding of brightness, distance, and magnitude. Let's now set our sights on Alpha Centauri, the star system closest to our own. We've just passed Sirius, and our own Sun is receding into the backdrop. Now, Alpha Centauri starts to guide our path. Observing a star isn't solely a visual endeavor, but also a journey through time. We're essentially time voyagers, receiving dispatches from the past each time we glance at the night sky. For instance, the light we perceive today from Alpha Centauri actually embarked on its trip roughly 4.37 years ago. Thus, we're observing Alpha Centauri not as it currently exists, but as it was over 4 years in the past. This realization underscores the phenomenal distances involved in space travel and astronomy. The stars we observe are not as they currently are, but as they once were. Time and space engage in a magnificent cosmic ballet, and we're merely spectators, left in awe by the spectacle. As our journey continues, with Alpha Centauri gradually brightening, we pass a point where it becomes more radiant than our Sun. This point is approximately 1.8 light-years from Earth. To put it differently, we're not even halfway to Alpha Centauri, yet it's already supplanted our Sun in terms of brightness. In the cosmic expanse, this point is the closest at which another star can appear brighter than the Sun from our perspective. Isn't it extraordinary how our comprehension of brightness can shift with changes in distance and viewpoint? Our celestial exploration persists as we draw nearer to Alpha Centauri A, one of the twin stars comprising the Alpha Centauri binary system. This stellar entity commands fascination, being larger and more luminous than our own Sun, outshining it with a brilliance 1.5 times greater. Remember when we considered the Sun as the most radiant star in our firmament? As we span these astronomical distances, our perspective undergoes a significant transformation. The Sun's radiance begins to fade in the spacecraft's rearview, while Alpha Centauri seizes the limelight, its luminosity the star of the cosmic theater. This juncture sparks a realization about the relativity of our universe. We witness a sort of stellar eclipse as Alpha Centauri A, now the most radiant body in our sky, overshadows the light from our Sun. It's a humbling nudge, reminding us of our role in the cosmos, and the enormity that extends beyond our solar system. But let's pause for a moment. What if our journey ventured in a different direction? What if we were to travel closer to the Sun? How near could we approach before another celestial entity outshone our Sun? The answer may be unexpected, and that's what we'll delve into in our subsequent segment. So, ensure your seatbelts are securely fastened as we gear up for a daring descent towards our solar system's core. As we initiate the next phase of our voyage, let's bid adieu to Alpha Centauri A and plot a course home, but not before making a brief detour. Our target is Mercury, the smallest and innermost planet in our solar system, just a stone's throw from the Sun, at least in cosmic terms. Visualize standing on Mercury's terrain, particularly on the side that's shrouded from the Sun. In this dark realm, the Sun is completely obscured from sight by the planet itself. Despite being in such proximity to the Sun, another celestial body would likely surpass it in brilliance in your sky, possibly another planet, depending on their relative positions. Mercury traces its path around the Sun with a notably high eccentricity, deviating substantially from a perfect circle. At perihelion, the nearest point in its orbit, Mercury is a mere 46 million kilometers away from the Sun, roughly a third of the average Earth's own distance. Here, in the shadows of Mercury, we are privy to an extreme instance of how perspectives can alter dramatically based on our cosmic coordinates. Suddenly, the Sun, the star that illuminates and supports life on Earth, turns into an unseen Titan, its presence only discernible through its gravitational pull. Ponder over this, a gaze towards a sky devoid of the Sun, where the brightest object is likely another planet, aglow with reflected sunlight. It's astonishing, isn't it? Yet, it is a reality, a perspective unique to Mercury's dark side. That concludes our interstellar journey for today. I trust you found it as engaging as I did. There's a wealth we can discover by simply adjusting our viewpoints, even if it's purely hypothetical. Remember, the spirit of space exploration isn't confined to telescopes and rockets. It's about curiosity, the audacity to pose questions and hunt for answers, no matter how remote they may appear. Before we conclude, if you found this cosmic adventure enjoyable, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and activate that notification bell. We'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments section, and invite you to share any cosmic curiosities you may have or any celestial phenomena you'd like us to examine next. As always, continue exploring, keep marveling, and let the cosmos be your compass.